Hey there, welcome to today's video tutorial, and this one is going to be super simple. Basically, sometimes when people put in their email address or other sensitive data, sometimes they might accidentally press the space bar at the end, and you don't want to record that extra space. So basically, what's going on here is I'm going to type in the exact same email as you can see on that blue box, except I'm going to go ahead and just put in a bunch of space afterwards. Okay, and now I'm going to press this button, and this is going to become the piece of string I just typed in. Well, without this little dot here, like so. And as you can see, it's the exact same piece of string, except this one has a bunch of space after the string has been typed in. And I'll even add a space bar right here in the beginning as well. Well, not a space bar, but you know, a bunch of spaces. And as you can see, it's the exact same string, except the only difference is the amount of extra spaces. However, if they match, once I press this button, this will go true. If they don't match, it'll stay false. So I'm going to press it, and as you can see, it's true. And I even printed them both here. As you can see, they are the exact same piece of string. And I'm going to show you exactly how to do this right now. Here we are again, and let me just go ahead and show you that right now, these two would not match. As you can see, the spaces are right there. And if I hit the check match, it's going to be false. And you know, the spaces are still here. You can't see it to this side. Well, you can now that I highlighted it, but the point is, you know now that it's not working. So just make sure you understood this variable right here is this one. And then this string right here, as you can see, it's this one right here. And this is the bool to check if this is true or false. And on the text field on submission, this string becomes whatever's on the text field. That much you probably already know. This is the variable being displayed on this box. And this is the variable being displayed on this box. Now, once I press this button right here, as you can see, we're doing set state. We're checking if these two match or not. And if they do match, then the variable is matched becomes true. Otherwise, it's still false. And then we print the two variables right here, just so you can see what it looks like. And that's about it. We're just showcasing the is matched variable right here, but that's it. I'm just going to go straight into showing you how to change this. So basically, the only thing that you won't need to do is come over here where you're actually trying to match both strings, and you just do dot trim. That's it. You do nothing else. So you pretty much just take this and you give it to both of them so that they are both trimmed before being compared. So we are actually comparing the trimmed versions of both. And when we print, we just do this as well, because you know, we're not actually transforming it into a trimmed version. We're just trimming it to check if they match. And that is literally it. Now if I restart the app and I come over here and again do compare, it's already here, awesome. And then I do the space bars like this, and I submit. All I gotta do is check match, and as you can see, it's true. So that's literally all you gotta do. Whenever you wanna check a piece of string against another, or for example, if you wanted to get this version of the text field, you just, you know, create a new variable. I'm trying to call this new variable, and this would be it. Now a new variable would literally be the same as this. So if I hit the save button and I do check match, of course, you know, there it is. There's no extra spaces or whatever. This is literally all you gotta do. In fact, this is literally what you should always do whenever you're receiving an email address. There are certain pieces of information that you should always trim. And now that you know how easy it is, there's no excuses. So I hope this video was able to help you in any way. If it did, please hit that like button. And of course, stay tuned for more tutorial videos by hitting that subscribe button. Thank you so much for watching. This is Flutter Mentor, and out.